Hello, everybody. Welcome back for the end of the Moon Knight series. Episodes 4, 5, and 6 are in this video, and if you missed my reaction to the first half of the series, click up here to go and check that out. I am loving it so far and cannot wait to see how they continue this story. My name is Kale. If you're new here, thank you so much for joining me, and as always, full-length watch-alongs are on my Patreon if you prefer that over the edited versions. I'm impatient. Let's get into it.
I want you to remember one thing.
I feel like they actually made a really good ending for like the halfway point of the show with Khonshu like being imprisoned and such. Like that was, you know, a good cliffhanger to leave the halfway mark with. There's other ones, a lot of them too. Oh, great. Love that for us. Sorry, I'm confused how they like didn't see them when they came. You're in a place full of sand and no obstacles. The only thing around here is this other truck. Let's not even bother checking the inside of it for the person that we saw running away. literally the only ridiculous part of this show so far. Y'all are dumb. Y'all are very dumb. Welcome back. Yeah, that was a little silly.
We're gonna need Mark, yeah?
Yes.
Exactly. See, she gets it.
Love that shot.
When he was done with Khonshu, he would disappear for good. But that deal didn't involve you getting Layla and us killed, did it?
You guys made a deal that he would just disappear from my life.
And you didn't think that maybe I should have been made aware of that?
Well, hadn't he disappeared from your life already?
Bro.
Give me the body right now. This is a suicide mission.
Plus, I know him. He'd want to lone wolf this whole thing. We're not going to do that.
I don't think I've mentioned it at all yet up until this point. With MCU stuff in Phase 4 so far, like, there's been a lot of just expanding into different cultures, and I've talked about that with a few of the different movies like Shang-Chi and Eternals and this series as well, like Middle Eastern culture, music, locations, people. Like, I just appreciate it. I really do. It's different. It's fun. It's not just the same old cookie cutter feeling of like America, you know? I know that we've had like pieces of different cultures in the MCU, but Phase 4 just feels like a lot more with it.
Without Khonshu, there's no more suit, no more healing, no more power. Yeah, no more you. Look, I wish I could just disappear. I really do. You gotta be smart, at least for Layla's sake. I've been in situations like this before.
So have I. It's the same body, isn't it? Muscle memory and that.
Yeah, I'm not sure it works that way. Just, no, whatever. Are you in love? Are you in love with my wife?
Finger on
we've
her.
Got it from here.
I swear to you,
so I need like a recipe for a protein shake or
I'll
something.
I'll call you.
Off a cliff!
I mean, you were technically in a, like, married to her and in a relationship with her. Seems important.
I feel like I've been waiting for this my whole life.
What we never had.
Yeah.
You smell like him. I mean, why wouldn't you, right?
Yeah. Mark's trying to protect you from Khonshu. That's why he's been pushing you away.
That must be so hard for her.
Why are you telling me this now?
Thought you deserved to know.
It wasn't his call to make. What I need is honesty. That's more of a you thing, isn't it?
Being honesty?
Being honesty. I'm gonna go down.
Okay.
First.
What, yeah. what's belay?
I still can't tell when you're joking or not.
Oh, poor Steven.
Oh, shit!
bro. So does that mean we're getting Mark now, or did Mark just quickly take over to do the punch and that was it? Oh, okay, now we got Steven back.
Oh, wow, look at you.
Oh, yeah, there's been stand and guard for centuries.
Right? No, I can't even...
Steven can't even right now.
Ask me a riddle for passage, I'd be thrilled. I'd shit myself, but I'd be thrilled.
She really likes Steven, and I like that.
Did you do that?
Yeah, it's for my father. He would have loved to be here. To him, it was a dream worth dying for. And he did.
I'm so sorry. I bet that he'd be positively beaming.
Yeah, I think so.
I really like these two. But I'd also be so curious to see what Mark and Layla were during their marriage, like, for the events of this series.
It's a maze.
It's amazing.
No, like there are six paths.
Yeah, whole structure. It's a symbol. It's a long line ending in a spiral. It's the tongue.
The avatar would be Ahmed's voice.
Oh my God, is that fresh blood?
Yeah, looks like it. Dragged.
Just a minute. What if there's maybe another?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Should we check it out?
Yeah, let's check it out.
All right.
Good.
Yeah.
So according to the ancient text, Ahmed should be bound to an Ushapti.
The exit.
Yeah, we can go this way. What are they shooting at?
Oh, I don't like the clicking. Hello? Oh, what is that thing? At least it's not like the Last of Us clickers. How do we quietly sneak away? Is that possible? I don't know.
Run! I'll find you! I squished it.
I don't know if he actually squished it. Maybe just hurt it, trapped it. I don't know. A long way down.
Steven?
That's not Steven. Of course, it has to be the tiniest ledge ever. Why are we zooming in? No, thank you. I was just about to say, as I was doing that, I was about to say, can we keep moving? Great. Ew. Oh, shit. Gross. Layla, why would your hand wasn't even on the ledge. Okay, deep breath. We also have to keep moving. We gotta find Steven. Arrow. Steven is literally in heaven right now.
Oh, it's got to be one of the biggins.
So, you kissed her.
Mark, come on.
What are you going to do, try and drown us now?
Yeah, I should. Told her the truth. That's why I've been pushing her away.
Wow, look at that. Look at all these relics.
Steven's like, I don't want to talk about this right now. We can talk about it later.
I think we're looking at the long-lost tomb of Alexander the Great.
You handled that beautifully.
Why do all men like you feel it necessary to be so condescending?
My little scarab. Isn't that what your father used to call you?
Why gotta be this way?
One of Egypt's most unique archaeologists. And your husband, he still hasn't told you the truth?
Well, you're obviously dying to.
I read his scales. The scales do not lie.
Okay. And?
Oh, everything inside me is like screaming not to open this thing.
Yeah, I bet.
Where's the Ushabti?
Alexander was the voice of Ahmet. I'll do something here. Sorry, Mr. Great.
Sorry, Mr. Great.
All right, open up.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Great. Oh, yeah, that's it. Get in there.
Okay, don't. Mark, you didn't have to say it like that.
Your father was murdered by mercenaries.
You're saying then, Mark was one of them?
You said it. What do you think? Mark remembers everything that happened that day. One man stands out, a fuchsia scarf, scarab details, handmade, made by his daughter, perhaps.
Are you done?
I do hope you find closure.
Ahmet?
Layla, look, we won!
And the Ushabti goes to us.
He's a little pissed right now.
You all right, love?
Can he hear me?
Alexander, I don't think so. God, I hope not.
What happened to my father? I'm talking to you, Mark! No.
We have to go right now.
Mark!
Layla, we have to go right now.
Did you kill Abdullah El Fouli?
Of course not. Of course I didn't.
So then what happened?
But you were there.
I was there.
How did he die?
My partner got greedy and he executed everyone at the dig site. I tried to save your father, but I couldn't save him. And
but you brought a killer right to him, right?
Let's not assume that he...
Yeah.
Yeah.
He shot me too. I was supposed to die that night. But I didn't die that night. I should have.
He didn't know his partner was a... Anyway.
Oh my God.
You knew when they met?
That's the reason that we met. You just had a guilty conscience.
That's complicated.
Go, find it. I'll hold them off.
I remember the first morning I woke up knowing that Kanchu was gone. The quiet was liberating. You have a very important decision to make.
That happened all so quick. So quiet, too.
I can't save anyone who won't save themselves.
I have the feeling something big is about to happen with him. Like, he can't be dead. Is that how the episode's gonna end, though? No, okay, we're good. That was a great transition, by the way. We're getting a flashback. Love the aspect ratio change, too, to the square. Or wait, maybe this isn't a flashback. Maybe we're literally watching, like, a movie or something.
No, but I'm just a lad trying to do my best. You're Dr. Stephen Grant.
Maybe so, but you've got pluck. Now let's see what we can find on our friend here.
B-22, everyone. B-22.
What the hell is going on? I feel like I'm watching WandaVision. Oh, those cupcakes look fucking delicious.
This is beautiful.
That looks like Khonshu.
Right, young man. Brakes are on. Your favorite spot.
I changed the movie, okay? It's
been 5 times this week. We won. We won.
Steven.
All right. And isn't this guy someone who worked with Harrow? Moon Knight action figure.
I know that you're having a great Dr. deal of difficulty Harrow. Being able to differentiate between what's real and what's in your head. I took the liberty of borrowing the film you brought. It was...
Film Buster.
How many times would you say you've seen that movie?
I think a lot.
Approximately.
Based on everything we've watched up to this point.
I like the villain.
You would.
No tree can ascend to the light of heaven if it doesn't deep.
Oh my gosh. What? What?
Mark, we don't live in a material world. We live in a psychic world. And all I'm asking of you is an honest assessment of your situation.
Everything reminds me
of your past. Of Steven.
You know Steven?
I know Steven. But Mark, I want to talk to you right now.
So if this is reality, well, we'll call it, which it feels like it is.
You are triggered, you're overwhelmed, and that's normal. All right, many of us, when asked to look into our innermost experiences,
So yeah, he created this whole thing in his head, taking bits and pieces from real life.
I can't help you if you don't help yourself. If we can't calmly sit and take inventory of your feelings, Mark.
Man, this is why I was not, I could have never, ever expected the story to go this way.
Manic episodes followed by depression.
From me.
Mark, don't do this. You're only gonna...
I was just about to be like, guard, help, staff, help.
Don't hurt him, all right?
Oh, no. I also like how his office were like the colors of the Moon Knight outfit that he was wearing. And that kind of looks like the hallway where he was the storage place. That he went to. I can't remember which episode that was.
Steven?
Hawk? Steven! Hawk! How is this possible?
I don't know. What's the last thing that you remember?
Harrow shot us.
Yes, exactly! We gotta get out of here.
Gosh, now we're getting them both side by side. My brain is so confused right now, so I am just... Oh, you tripping.
Hi.
You tripping hard. That's how they end the episode? Jesus. Okay. You know what? I genuinely don't even know that I have anything to say about this episode. My brain is mush. Actual mush. I was so on board with like how the whole episode was going. And then chaos. And then Mark. Yeah. Mark had taken over. Mark got shot. And then... boom, it's like we're watching a completely different show. Anyway, I think that my brain wants to believe that the real Mark and Steven are in a facility of some kind, in a place of care, hopefully, like people that genuinely, you know, are treating them well and give a shit about them. And I am inclined to believe that they fabricated this all in their mind because they're the same person. So even if one identity and personality creates something in their mind, like the other one will still know about it because you can't completely close them off. You can't always completely close them off from one another, right? Like, yes, there's the blipping stuff that happened earlier in the show. And that is valid where like one of them will completely lose time. But I'm more so meaning like, it's like creating a dream kind of, or creating like some kind of alternate reality to live through. And so it's like when he got shot, that was what like kicked them out of that fabricated dream world and back to reality. That is how my brain wants to understand what's going on right now. So that is all I will say. Let's go into episode 5, which is called Asylum. Asylum. I don't know why. I don't like that word. I feel like asylum, for most people, that's just like has more of a negative meaning to it, or like a negative, like, you know, just more of a negative vibe to it. Anyway, Asylum is the next episode. Let's do it.
Right, world's first bogeyman.
I'm really curious how they're going to set up this previously on. Like, what are they going to choose to show us?
You brought this upon yourself, Khonshu.
Yeah, so who is Khonshu in reality? If I'm, like, who did Mark make Khonshu?
This is all your fault!
Calm down, Mark! I didn't shoot you. Your mind is violently vacillating between sense and nonsense. You are my patient here at Putnam Medical Facility in Chicago, Illinois, and a reassuring fantasy that you've created on your own. I don't know, superhero, all right? You're doing everything and everything possible. Not.
Oh my gosh.
Is that why you keep starting imaginary fights in our hospital?
You're not a doctor.
I feel like a real doctor.
You're not a doctor.
Let's try it your way. Retrace your steps. How did you come to be here today?
How did you get here?
I took the bus, like I always do. You told me that you were in a place that was oddly reminiscent of this office, except that it was in Egypt, with a rhinoceros and
hippopotamus.
And it talked. Do you think that is sense or nonsense?
The struggling mind will often build places to seek shelter from our most traumatic memories.
I should have thought maybe the whole story with Layla's dad was actually his dad. And that was his way of like detaching the situation from himself, sort of. Because he said he was there, but he wouldn't tell Layla what happened.
Before you got upset, you were talking to me about a boy. You think you could tell me about that little boy?
Hey, thank you. I feel really great.
They must pay you a lot of money in this place.
You know
you're really good. Doctor,
Listen, Mark, be gentle with him. Listen, I am not your enemy. No!
Well, these minutes are really amazing.
This will really bake your noodle, but I think you were just taking a little time out. I'm afraid you are actually quite dead.
Yes, Mark, I think she's right. I think we died.
It's been a minute since we've had a soul pass through here. To the realm of the Juat.
Juat, the Egyptian underworld. This is Tawerit. She's guiding us through our journey to the afterlife. Wow.
The afterlife?
An afterlife, not the afterlife.
I love the voice.
Mark.
That's the reality. Mark. And this is the hospital. That's the imagination.
Oh, man. Dr. Harrow's right. Dr. Harrow?
We go through here. There's going to be a bunch of patients.
Oh, my God. I'm dead. Where did you say we're going? We're sailing to our route.
So he's the smart one, hey?
Easy.
Oh, goody. It worked. Look at that.
Oh, she's weighing our hearts on the scales.
It's definitely, well, I shouldn't say definitely. This feels like just Mark under that. I feel like they sedated him, and now we're experiencing that.
No unbalanced souls on my boat. Them's the rules. Fingers crossed for you guys, hey?
There's no way we're ending up down there.
All right, what are you proposing?
Kill the hippo, steal the boat.
Kill? Why is it doing that? Why is it moving like that?
I don't know. It's the hearts. They aren't full. It's like they each feel incomplete.
What does that mean?
Without balanced scales, Juat will eventually claim your soul. Now, I don't know what you two guys have been hiding, but my advice, you get in there and show each other the truth.
So how are we supposed to do this?
This whole thing feels like a way for Mark and Steven, these two very different identities and personalities, to finally cooperate once and for all in the real world.
Or we can do what she says and like help each other uncover whatever it is that we're hiding, apparently. Steven. I don't know about you, but my memories are a frickin' mess.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Mine too.
Whoa.
That was such a cool scene. I like how that one was labeled treatment room.
Oi, what's this?
This is bedroom. I missed the first one. I don't know if that matters or makes a difference, but...
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, it's the street.
Oh, how
this
is...
How many streets have you walked down your whole life? Just a creepy calf filled with dead bodies. You killed all of them? They were criminals, murderers. Can't you wanted them punished? Now what do we do? You go next, or? Who's that? Mark, why is there a child in a room filled with people that you've killed? Steve, don't
hey,
go near him.
Man.
Oh.
What's your name there? Oh,
uh-oh.
Hold on there. Wait a moment. Wait a moment.
Wait. No, wait, Steve.
Roro?
He drew the fish with only one fin.
Mark, be nice to your little brother.
Brother. Oh no, something bad.
Have you gone too long?
Hey, Mark.
Keep an eye on your brother, okay?
Was his brother's name Steven?
Okay, fine.
Randall.
Can you hear that, Dr. Grant?
I sure do, Rosa.
Dr. Grant?
Mom said not to when it's raining.
It'll be fine, I'm your baby.
I'm so nervous. Sorry, I'm super quiet this episode because I'm just like, I'm so, what's happening? I want clarity. I'm trying to like pay attention to details and see if it helps explain.
Boys! Don't go any further!
I think you're in a memory. There's nothing you're going to be able to do.
Where are they?
Yeah, it's dangerous.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Mark! Oh God! Follow my voice!
It's just a memory. It's just a memory. Hey, Steven.
What are you doing here? You were supposed to keep him safe?
Steven, let's go.
This is all your fault!
Stop!
Wendy? Wendy, come on, please. We're just about to blow out the candles now.
She's not coming.
Damn, dude.
We'll do it just you and I this year. Okay?
Sucks so bad. So Mark has really suppressed all of this. So much so that even Steven just is completely unaware.
I should have known you would do something like this.
Mom, what are you doing?
What happened to that roof, Mark?
That's it.
All right.
Why are you remembering her like that? It's not what she was like.
Not in your memory, at least.
What are you hiding?
Mark, son, please come inside. She will get help. You're supposed to fix this. I mean, why haven't you?
I cannot lose another son.
Man. Where are we now?
Vehicle?
Harrow said you were a mercenary.
And you believe that?
Yeah. Wouldn't put it past you. Turns out going AWOL in a fugue state gets you discharged from the military. So I went work for hire for my old CO, Bushman.
The job was to raid an Egyptian tomb. Bushman changed the plan, called for no witnesses, and I couldn't live with that.
Is that Dr. Ofuli?
And here we go.
What happened to you?
So when... I'm gonna... Hang on. Hang on.
I feel the pain inside of you. I am the god Khonshu, in search of a warrior to bind your very being to me. Do you want death or do you want life?
I don't know. He was manipulating you from the start.
I kept us alive.
The scales. Have we done it? Have we balanced them?
Just about.
Then rise. Rise and live again as my Moon Knight.
Hero, you see why we have to go back?
Can you send word to Layla? Please help us free Khonshu.
Are you sure you want to be with Khonshu again?
It's where it's gotta be.
Osiris is not going to like this, but his gate is the only path back.
Okay. I think that IRL Mark, is in a sedated state. And the way that this story began for us as the viewer, we're going to get an ending to that right now. Like, what's about to happen?
Back at the house, there was that bedroom that you didn't want me to go into. That's it. That's what we're Just wait a second. Just give me a second here. We can just talk. Let's just talk.
Right. Let's talk. Yeah.
Don't make us go there again. It's not worth it.
Not worth it? Mark, you're about to lose everything. If Layla dies, that's on your head.
No, you can't! I won't do it! You can't make me! Didn't you inject me with something? Mm-hmm.
You watch too many movies, all right? We can't involuntarily sedate patients. Not these days.
What you've been doing is so difficult. Reliving these kind of traumatic memories can be so painful.
I'm so proud of you, Mark. Now just stay with me for one second, okay? Do you think you created Steven to hide from all the awful things you feel you've done in your life?
Yep.
Do you think Steven created Mark to punish the world for what your mother did to you?
Ooh, that's actually, that's a good question. I do think it's the former, it's the former. But maybe not, I don't know.
Can you open up to Steven?
Let's do it. Let's get some progress up in here.
I don't...
The fish with one fin! The drawing of the fish! That's the fish he had in the apartment!
It's not my mom.
Mark opened his mom. Must have really... Oh, the... Sorry, I'm looking at all the details of the room.
Oh. Bloody hell. Look at the state of this place. Better sort it out before mom sees it.
Mark, open the door right now!
Scales.
When danger is near, even Grant has no fear. You made me up.
Open the door right now!
You're gonna learn to listen.
Oh, I hate this. So Mark made Steven.
I want to see what she did. Disgusting.
You're not meant to see that. You're not meant to see that. That's the whole point of you.
Oh, the point of me, what, to be a stress ball? All this time I thought I was the original. You've got to live a happy, simple, normal life. But it was all a lie, wasn't it? You had a mother that beat you, that hated you. You've gotten to live thinking that she loved you, that she was kind, that she's still alive. Let me out. Oh, you gave me a real start there.
It's back to Steven.
Steven, hold on a minute.
What's this?
It's good to see you again.
I wonder how long it's been since Dr. Harrow has seen him.
Well, you've really gone up in the world, haven't you?
I was beginning to worry we might never speak again.
Little silly Tash there. It's very Ned Flanders.
Ned Flanders.
Did he get a chance to speak with you?
He lied to me, that's what he did.
Mm-hmm. Steven, when you first came in here, I was worried you were never even going to be able to acknowledge Mark.
What do you mean when I brought us here?
After your mother passed.
Don't say that. That's not true. That's not true.
Oh, I'm so, I must...
Are you having a laugh as well? Say that again. My mother is alive. I will freak out, I promise.
I must be mistaken. What do we call her? Could you call Mrs. Grant, please?
No, she screens a call. She won't answer. No, please don't do that.
It's ringing. Mrs. Grant? Yes, this is Dr. Harrow. Would you like to speak to your mother?
I cannot tell if this is like a role play on Harrow's part to try to help or
is dead. Her mom is dead.
Okay. The first three episodes and the start of the fourth was like... And ever since then, it's been... This is so heartbreaking and so sad.
Not giving you that satisfaction.
And Oscar is doing like an incredible, like phenomenal job at acting in this show. Like I think this is my favorite role. Like we're not even done, and I feel like this is my favorite role that I've seen of his. I haven't seen everything Oscar's been in, but I've seen quite a few things. Switched.
What? Bloody hell, what? Not again. Hey, Mum. Hey, you all right? Yeah, would you believe it? I am totally lost. Yeah, sorry.
This is it. Mom's death in Shiva 2 months ago. This was the moment our lives started bleeding into each other.
I couldn't face that again. For all the things I'd done. She was wrong. It wasn't your fault.
I shouldn't have brought him in that cave.
Hey.
Blame yourself.
You were just a child. It wasn't your fault.
Are the scales balanced, finally? Are they gonna be?
The gates of Osiris. Come on, hurry! Don't it. What's happening?
I've never seen the gates to the world above so close. Your scales never balanced. Our journey's come to an end. I cannot stop the inevitable.
They're close, though. They're close. Oh my gosh, these effects.
You've got this.
Means I've got this too.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it does. Hell yes. Find you. Do you feel like we just saw like maybe a bit of Mark there though? Oh gosh. Song, right? Song that was hummed. Bruh. Man, I didn't. There was a part of me that thought that maybe the scales could only get balanced if Steven were to not be around. But I didn't want that as the outcome, though. I wanted the scales to be balanced by them, like, 100% trusting, letting out all the truth and stuff. Now, here's the thing. There is still a whole episode to go, so maybe this isn't the case. Like, maybe Steven and Mark can still coexist together. But, oh my gosh. This is... I'm so interested in the comics for this. Very much interested in reading them and just seeing... more of this character and more of the story. And I'm so glad that they made it into a short series like this, which really just feels like a very long movie. This series more than some of the others. Like Hawkeye felt like a TV show. What If felt like a TV show. Loki feels like a TV show. WandaVision, Falcon Winter Soldier, like those all felt like TV shows. This to me genuinely feels like a long movie, which is fun. And earlier I said that I wasn't sure if by the end of this series I was gonna like want more out of it and kind of have the mindset of wishing that it would be 9 episodes instead of 6, but No, there's a big part of me now that thinks that this final episode is gonna like feel it decent and that I'm gonna be like, nope, this was great the way it was. Because that's how I feel right now. We've got one episode to go, and currently I feel very pleased with the storytelling of this and how this has been presented to us. And Oscar Isaac's acting is just, it's so good. I have really, really loved his performance, especially these scenes where the two of them are together and we're seeing Mark and Steven as two separate bodies on screen at the same time. And then also the scenes where we then had a third Oscar Isaac when both of them were watching adult Mark and then adult Steven, right? So we had essentially duplicates of both. Oh my gosh, it gets confusing explaining it a little bit, but yeah, I am digging this. Absolutely digging this. I cannot wait to see this final episode. I really hope that we get another Layla scene though. I miss her. I really do. And oh, my opinion on Harrow now? Yeah. The real version, like the Dr. Harrow, he's great. What else do I have to say? I don't think I have anything else to say about, this back half really just whoosh turned. Oh my gosh. I don't know how this is gonna end. I'm hoping for a happy ending though. And with that, you know what? Let's just get into the final episode. Gods and Monsters, here we go. Now we're back here.
I'm sorry it had to be this way. Mark Spector, Stephen Grant, whoever else might be in there.
Layla.
Who wants to heal the world?
Mark.
I wasn't expecting us to actually come back to this after last episode.
It's all right.
I don't need to show you my papers. You need to show us your soul.
Okay.
Goddess, to wear it. Layla. It's Mark who's telling you to stop.
Oh.
He's dead. And I'm talking to you through dead people right now. So what?
Oh, gosh.
If he can return to life.
What do you mean?
He is going to need Khonshu. Break his Shabti, and you can be my avatar. Mark says wonderful things.
Oh, gosh. My brain is continuing to feel like mush.
Someone is trying to release Amit.
Haro. You won't believe what the gods have hidden from mankind.
I guess we do need a conclusion to this part of, I mean, in this show we've spent so much time here, so we do need a conclusion to it.
Your scales lack balance.
I understand.
They lack balance because of what lies ahead of you. Your death is delayed. You are the avatar that I need.
Okay. Khonshu's back out.
I do not sense Mark Spector in this world. He died fighting, no doubt.
Your war.
Would you, Layla Elfuri, protect the travelers of the
You
night.
Joking? You turned Mark's life into a waking nightmare.
You won't win against Harrow and Amit alone. Mark was in crisis over you. His lack of focus got him killed. You need a plan, little bug.
Mark didn't trust you. I don't trust you. We'll work together without me enslaving myself.
We must rebind Amit.
I said no.
I feel like you almost don't have a choice right now.
Time has been cruel to you.
I cannot allow you to proceed.
The scales are balanced. Your heart is full. Your journey is over.
I don't know that he feels that way, though.
It's so quiet.
The peace you've always wanted but never had.
What about Stephen?
He's gone, Mark. The Duat has him. Enjoy your peace.
We need to go back for him.
You don't need him anymore, Mark.
So I get to go on to eternal peace and he just stays lost in the sand forever? No, I'm not good with that.
Aww. Go get Steven.
You're looking pretty rough, man. I don't know if you can hear me. From the moment you arrived, way back then, we were so young. You saved me. I survived because I knew I wasn't alone. You were always there. Full of hope, and I tried to protect that, and I failed. I couldn't protect you. But you didn't abandon me. You didn't abandon me. And although that field back there was looking pretty good. There's no way in hell I'm gonna abandon you. You're the only real superpower I ever had.
No. He's really kind and sweet. Steven. His scale's gotta be hella balanced now, right? Please?
You came back. What the hell's wrong with you? Well, I did a whole little speech there. I wasn't that little.
You asshole.
The gates are open.
Jeez. Run? Run!
I'm throwing us down! Just go! Come on, Mom!
Nobody's getting left behind.
Look! Osiris, you old softy! Now run!
Hippo!
Mark?
Ooh. Felt him return.
Do you want death? Or do you want life? Do you swear to protect the travelers of the night?
Whoa. He just went, I'm gonna push these bullets out of me.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Can't you? Layla turned you down, didn't she?
Amit has been freed. I was not strong enough to stop her. I need your help.
Just curious about something.
Was not speaking to you.
Yeah, all right, but we do come as like a package deal now, mm-hmm. So you are going to have to deal with me. How's this deal going to work?
I will release you both. You have my word.
Glad we got that all sorted out. Now, how the heck are we going to get to Cairo?
I am still the god of the night sky.
Mm-hmm. I think you can take this one, Mark.
Idiots.
Ooh, loved that.
We need to imprison Ahmed. In a mortal form.
A body instead of a statue.
Make her human? Oh, crap.
Toadette, are you there? Layla!
Could have been quieter about that.
Delighted. Your father is going to be over the moon when he hears.
My father?
Yes, I met him when I took him to the field of reeds.
Back and forth here. And I love that it's not cut, but we can actually see the actress like going from one to the other. Wow, what a view.
Followers of Ahmet, judge. Everyone!
Oh boy. Man, rewatching this, there's so many things that are gonna make so much more sense now. Ooh, look at her! Love it. Love the outfit. Oh shit, hello? Okay, I need a show with her now, please. Wearing that all the time. Ooh, love this, love this, love this. That was one of my favorite shots in the whole show. Oh, and the back and forth between Mark and Steven. Damn.
I only punish those who have chosen evil.
So do I. Only I don't give them the satisfaction of committing it.
Hell yeah.
Mark.
Oh, baby.
Aww.
Thank God you're...
How did you get back?
Wow, you look amazing. What are you wearing?
That's what I'm saying.
Wi-Fi. Knowing you will fail.
It is my choice. The very thing you'll take away.
I liked that line. Mm-hmm. She gives me Falcon vibes. It's the wings. It's the wings, of course. Ooh, look at him go. Ooh. Yes. Yes. Yes, Steven. Shouldn't have lifted your leg like that. Hell yeah, Mark. Aww.
Is the superhero Mosreya?
Yes. Dude, I fucking love her. Hello?
Had Ahmed been allowed to rule, young Randall's life would have been saved. Your family would have been happy. She need only remove one weed from the garden.
Come on, Moon Knight. Come on, Moon Knight.
A chance, mate.
What the hell was that?
I blacked out.
Get Haro. I know how to stop Ahmet.
We could have made this our paradise.
You will be destroyed.
And Ahmet's defeated.
Leave neither of them alive.
Okay, one more step.
While he lives, so too does she.
Mark! You have a choice.
She will kill again.
I sound just like her.
Yeah.
You want them dead.
Do it yourself.
Do it yourself.
As you wish.
Are we about to be? Yeah. Okay.
So what? This is what reality looks like?
The imagination is very real.
But do you believe that Khonshu and Ahmet are real?
No.
What if we disagree, Doc?
Mark.
What if we believe something different?
Then our work here continues.
For how long?
How long is a piece of string?
Yeah, you see that, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Why am I bleeding?
Well, it is tempting to accept your diagnosis, Doc.
We'd rather go save the world. Later, skaters.
Steven, you there?
Hey. Yep, is Mark?
Can't believe it worked.
Oh, two fish. One with one fin, one with two.
I can't believe you live in this frickin' mess.
Is that how it ends? That episode felt so fast. Okay, well, it was 35 minutes, so that explains why. And that includes like the previously on and the intro and everything. So yeah, that was the shortest episode by far. But it seems like we've got a long credit scene. All right.
Time for bed.
Yo me lo llevo. Tranquila, señorita, tranquila.
Okay, so he is a patient. Scale tattoo still.
Can't you? You can't hurt us.
Mark Spector truly believed that after he and I parted ways, I wanted his wife to be my avatar. When he has no idea how troubled he truly is. Meet my friend, Jake Lockley.
Hoy te toca perder.
Wait.
So it was Jake. Love license plate, Spector. So Jake was the one that killed him because both Mark and Steven didn't, both of them said they didn't kill Arrow. confusing, but so good. Okay, well, that was a really interesting ending for this show. Makes me really wonder if we're getting a season two, because that post-credits scene was very much setting up more of the story. Jake Lockley, yeah, he has to be the one that killed Arrow, because Mark and Steven both were like, wasn't me. So the only explanation is for a third identity, a third personality in, like, that is with Mark and Steven. And it seems like this Jake identity is the original that Khonshu brought on. Like, I know that this whole story was told with, like, he made Mark his avatar, but I can't help but feel like whoever this Jake, I love that he's Spanish, by the way. I love that each of these identities have very distinctive accents and personalities. Even just that little bit we got of this Jake character, like, Oscar did such a great job portraying him for these few seconds just to, like, give us that little sneak peek. But yeah, it almost feels like Jake was the original avatar now. Man, what a fascinating story for the MCU. So unlike anything that we've had so far. I really, really appreciate the exploration of a condition like dissociative identity disorder and bringing that into a superhero thing. I'm definitely gonna wanna know if this is, like, straight out of the comics. It's gotta be. I can't see them, like, completely changing a character for a TV show like this. But yeah, this was really, really good, really fascinating. I had a really, really great time. I already cannot wait to rewatch this, because when it comes to stories about people that have DID, there's always signs, there's always, like, details and little indications. So by going back to episode one, knowing how this whole thing plays out, now I can pay a little bit more attention. And I think that a lot of conversational aspects and details will make a lot more sense to me now, and I'll be able to pick them up easier. And it's funny, because, like, I don't recall being super confused by what was being presented to us for the first 3.5, we'll say, episodes. But then, of course, episode four then just went, bloop, we're flipping the table over. And I think my favorite episode, though, was episode five. Episode five just exploring the memories and kind of bringing Steven up to date on everything and finally getting to understand like who was the main and who was the creation. Because it's my understanding, at least, that people that have DID, like, it's never from, like, birth. Like the altar is always formed at some point, right? And often it's in childhood. So it was nice to finally just get an understanding of, like, where that started, where it came from, the why behind it, and getting that clarification that Mark, it was, like, Mark was the, like, he was born Mark. And Steven was the addition, we'll call it. As for like Mark and Steven, Oscar played them both so differently that it's hard to see them as the same. They're so, I don't know, they're so different, and I love them both for different reasons. I lean more towards Steven. I really, really adore Steven's personality and just who he is. And Oscar, I think, did a great job with the accent for one. He was just really great. And I also really adored Steven's relationship with Layla as well. And then I also really liked Mark, though, definitely from like the fighting aspect of things, for sure. Like he's a really good fighter, and I just has a more like forward personality, I guess we'll call it. Not going to speak to Jake because we don't know him like at all. So but this makes me really hope that we get more of this, because I definitely want more. That said, remember when I said that I wasn't sure if by the end, like, listen, these 6 episodes, fantastic. Honestly, don't need 9. Don't need 9. This felt like a long movie. This felt like a long movie that wrapped up as if we're going to eventually get like a second long movie. So I'm happy with how this was presented. I'm happy with how it was told. I am going to cross my fingers and toes for a second part to this and have it continue. And it better be Oscar Isaac still, because at this point, nobody else could do that. He was so good in this. Like, I can't even express. He was awesome. Definitely, now that this is over, on all 6 episodes are in my brain, out of everything I've seen Oscar in, this is my favorite. This is my favorite of his. He was good. He was very, very good. This series, more than any one in the MCU so far, I want to, like, behind the scenes, I want to know, like, how filming went, especially from Oscar's perspective with handling this. I want to know all the behind the scenes details and like the prep work that went into this. I want to know stuff about just the different aspects of filming. I think that this series, out of everything, has had the most like creative cinematography. The way that they handled Mark and Steven initially before we got to see them separate was really awesome. All the different reflection choices and the camera angles to get there and everything like that, I thought was really lovely. And it was just visually really appealing to the eyes. I loved it. Let's talk about Layla now, though, because I really enjoyed Layla. She was really, really growing on me throughout this whole series. And then this final episode where she dons her outfit and jumps in and fights definitely reminded me of like a female Falcon. She was fantastic, and I want more of her now too. In that exact outfit, fighting, using her wings to fight and block and all of that. Oh my gosh, she was great. She was great. And she was just a great character. It was nice to get some understanding on what her and Mark went through. But I think, like, aside from this final episode, seeing her fight like she did, I mean, I also loved her fighting when she was just herself. I think my favorite part of Layla, though, was how she didn't know about Steven, for one. But then once she got to meet Steven and she was spending so much time with him, you could tell that she was kind of like falling in love with him, you know? She just really liked him. And I think it was Steven's knowledge of all of this Egyptian stuff and kind of nerding out about it that really appealed to her. And it's a big reason why he appealed to me as well. I love when people are super passionate and nerdy about their interests and hobbies and stuff. So that was really lovely to watch. Ethan Hawke, love that man. Him as Harrow, Arthur Harrow, both versions, the Egyptian bad guy, and then also the doctor just really trying to help Mark and Steven. He was great. Ethan Hawke, I mean, his performances I always enjoy. Gonna plug my Before trilogy reactions. If you haven't seen them, would recommend. Loved Ethan Hawke in all those movies. I have nothing bad to say. Ethan was great. Loved his scenes, and I'll just leave it at that. I don't know a whole lot about Egyptian culture. but from what I can gather from this series, it feels like they did things appropriately. It feels legit, is what I'll say. For those of you that are watching that know a hell of a lot more than I do, I would appreciate your insight on that. All of the gods and the tombs and everything, let me know in the comments. I think the last thing that I want to talk about is kind of the superhero aspect of this, because out of everything in the MCU so far, Moon Knight had like the lowest amount of superhero stuff in it. And I'm sure that for a lot of you, that's probably a flaw. I don't recall mentioning it in any of the episodes, because I think I wanted, in my brain, I was like, let's just wait until I've watched the whole thing and then I'll talk about it. But during this show, it was probably like around episode 2 or 3, I kind of actually thought about that in my mind. I'm just like, we're not really actually seeing Moon Knight a whole lot. Like, this is like a Mark and Steven show. This is the Mark and Steven show, and we are following him along. And then, of course, Moon Knight 2, like, once we kind of got this confirmation that Mark is in like an institution and is being treated and trying to be helped by doctors and stuff, right? Then it kind of made me think in my mind, like, Moon Knight isn't real and Moon Knight is just a figment of his imagination, kind of like an alter as well. But here's the thing, like, I really don't mind. And that's also kind of why I'm hoping for more, I guess, is because maybe this initial 6 episodes, if the plan is for more to come, then maybe this initial 6 episodes is just like really developing the background of the like human version of the superhero, right? Giving us that insight and explanation of like who he is as a person. And we're people, because Mark and Steven are just very distinct, and now they're in a stage of cooperation and you know, seamless flowing back and forth between one and the other, and they're balanced, their scales are balanced, right? So now that the scales are balanced, maybe in these next 6 episodes now, if they're gonna come, then we get more Moon Knight, and both versions of Moon Knight, right? We got the Mark Moon Knight that does a lot more. Well, Steven's Moon Knight can put up a fight too. But again, just having that kind of interchangeable back and forth between the two. I don't know. I'm not sure. Okay. Just Googled because I was curious. Doesn't look like Marvel has any immediate plans for a season 2. That's okay. I will now join the rest of you that want a season 2. I would also love a season 2. Or even if he appears in anything in the future in a big enough way, that would also be a big hype. I think that wraps up my thoughts on Moon Knight as a whole. I'm sure a lot of you are wondering where I would rank this. In terms of ranking it with all the other series so far, this is like top two. This and WandaVision. This and WandaVision are up there strictly because of how unique both are relative to any other form of storytelling in the MCU. I really appreciate how both of these stories were told and the way that it went. And I appreciate how both shows tackled issues, we'll call it. Not saying that DID or you know, depression are issues necessarily, but you know what I mean? Like, you know, WandaVision was great for grief, not depression, grief. Grief, yeah, WandaVision was a grief show. Moon Knight is a DID show. And yeah, I think both were handled very well and had some very unique storytelling. So, but between the two, like, which is number one, which is number two, give me some time to rewatch both and then I will let you know. And with that, it is now that time of the video where I turn it to you. Talk about Moon Knight in the comments. Let's heck and go. Not just your thoughts on these last 3 episodes, but the series as a whole. Do you want to see more of Mark and Steven and Moon Knight? Do you want to know more about this Jake character? Do you like the Moon Knight comics? Like, yeah, let me know your thoughts on all of this. I cannot wait to read them. And also, if Moon Knight was not your cup of tea, definitely let me know why as well. If you're not yet subscribed, thank you so much for doing so. You can click here to do it. And if you're already subscribed, thank you. And to keep watching Something Else of Mine, click on over here. We'll see you back here for the next reaction. Until then, have a great rest of your day. Cheers, everybody.